My dear brothers and sisters, Father Senior Rob Memkiewicz, Chairman of our Future Direction Committee of our Holy Polish National Catholic Church, I just finished celebrating Mass on this fourth Sunday of Lent and prayed for all of you, and many of our parishes are streaming this Mass, and that is a wonderful thing that we can participate, even if not being present in our churches during this time of this virus outbreak. But we're called, especially today, where Jesus calls us not to be spiritually blind, but to open our eyes, to be his disciples, and we can do that. We can be his disciples today. We've seen examples of those who have not been disciples hoarding different things, food and paper supplies, but we also have seen wonderful examples of discipleship, of being caring, being Jesus to others, especially in this time of need. And we're called to do that. This year, our Lenten journey has taken a different turn, but it's still a Lenten journey where we come closer to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And especially now, when we call upon our Lord in prayer, he wants us to be his disciples, to go out in whatever way we can, in a careful manner. There are different things we can do as his disciples, of course. Increase our prayer. We can reach out to those in nursing homes who can't have visitors with letters and cards of the sort. Check in on neighbors, on parishioners, on friends, on those who are elderly and see what we can do. Do shopping for them if they need it. We can always leave a bag of groceries outside their door to keep the social distancing that we must keep during this time. But there are ways that we can be our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to others. And as we continue to reflect on discipleship and strengthening our discipleship, let us strengthen that especially now during this time of need. I'm simply sending a link for Joanne Fabrics for those who know how to sew to make masks and bring them back to that store to be given out to first responders to come up and try to address in a small way the great need that we're going through across our communities, across our nation, and across our world. My brothers and sisters, our Lord continues to call us to follow him. We know he's there for us to calm all the storms in life. He's there with us right now during this COVID-19 outbreak, there to be with us. Reach out to him in prayer and continue to be his hands, his feet, his mouth, his eyes, his ears, and the way that we can share his love, share his goodness, share his presence with others. I'd like to end this brief message by offering the prayer of our church in time of national anxiety. Let us pray. We come to you, Lord, in this time of uncertainty and confusion that has gripped our nation. We pray that our leaders and representatives in government are filled with your peace, strength, and courage. May your gifts of wisdom and understanding, fortitude, and counsel be sought and utilized by them for the well-being of our country. By their belief and trust in you, may they provide capable leadership, promote unity and peace, and be attentive to the concerns of our people. May your church provide support and comfort and help and strengthen our hope for peace through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May God bless you all. May God bless our Holy Church. May God bless our country and our world. Amen.